Welcome everybody, thanks for being here. So I am Matteo Salardi from Yogitech. We are an independent company and we are a partner of ST. And Yogitech is specialized on functional safety applied to the integrated circuits. And through this presentation we will see how the STM32, which was not designed for functional safety, actually can be used also for functional safety projects thanks to our software libraries. So, well, first of all, functional safety, what is that? So, it's about preventing a wrong behavior in the circuits to cause injuries or hurt people. There are a lot of functional safety standards depending on the specific application. But there is the mother standard of all of them is the IEC 61508. That is the top standard. Then there are more specific standards focused on more specific domain. And Yogitech is very active in the IEC 61508 working group and also on the ISO 26262, which is the standard for functional safety applied to automotive. So thanks to our work on the standards, we have the know-how to apply functional safety to integrated circuits. So what we've done with the STM32, of course, when we start working with ST, the STM32 was already out there in the market and the hardware couldn't be changed anymore. But what we've done is first we've done a safety analysis. And basically we have done a list of all the all the safety requirements that must be fulfilled in order to be to use the STM32 in a SIL2 or SIL3 application. Now, some of the requirements are already covered by the hardware, even though it was not designed for functional safety. Others are really application specific and they have to be covered by the end user. But some safety requirements that can be covered by software in a way that is independent of the specific application. And here is where our library comes. So we have prepared this library that basically addresses all the safety requirements that can be covered without having any knowledge of the application. What is important to say is that basically we used a white box approach in contrast of a black box approach. What does this mean? So usually if people they have to test, let's say a Cortex-M core, they will take the data sheet, they will do some guess, maybe they will assume that all the faults are equally distributed, and they will try and implement their own library. This is what we call a black box approach. What we've done is a white box approach, which means we have this partnership with ST. ST provided us with a hardware database of the STM32. If some of you is familiar on integrated circuits, so basically we received the netlist and the RTL of the design. And based on that, we applied our analysis. So we there is no guessing. It's really looking into the circuits down at the gate level. And then also we don't have to assume that the faults are equally distributed. In fact, we will we designed our library to focus on those parts of the circuits that they had that they give the highest contribution in terms of failures, and of course this allows us to be to have an optimized software. And so we have done this using our methodology, so we which is a patented approach for analyzing integrated circuits. Really, in a nutshell, this approach means that we take the netlist. We divide into elementary part. For each part, we compute all the metrics. And then there is also a third step, which is about verification of the metrics using fault injection. So we inject all the faults at the gate level and see if the metric was accurate. So yeah, so this is exactly what I was saying now. So basically, using our methodology, we have this very accurate analysis of the, in this case, of the STM32. And basically from this analysis, we could derive the specification of our software and also the verification plan. What is this verification plan? Well, basically, it's like a simulation. So we load the netlist And we have a golden image, which is the STM32 netlist without fault injected. And then in parallel, we have we simulate the netlist with fault injected. So all faults are simulated. We run our software on top of that. And basically, we count how many faults we can detect. So of course, this is many of our customers, they try to do something like this by themselves. But then for them, it's very hard to measure what is the actual diagnostic coverage, because you don't know, basically. In this case, we have measured it, and in the documentation, there is the number, it's reported. So of course, this means that you have a state-of-the-art solution, with very accurate. You know exactly what is the coverage contribution given by this library. About the partnership with ST, so we've done this safety analysis, and the first output of this safety analysis has been the safety manual of the STM32. This safety manual is now property of ST, so if you want to have a look at it, please contact the ST people. And basically, in this safety manual, you will find all the list of the safety requirements that you have to fulfill to reach toward SIL 3. Then, of course, then at this point, on top of that, you have two options. You can either do your own development, you can do your own library, or you can come to us and get our library. And basically, our library is testing the Cortex M core, the RAM, the flash, and part of the peripherals. So basically, the library is doing that. You take the library, you plug in into your application, and then after this integration, which is quite straightforward, then you can reach SIL 2, SIL 3 on your project. It's important to mention that these libraries are certified by TÜV Rheinland, that they are absolutely application independent. So usually we have almost no visibility of how our customers are using it. So in any kind of product, from robotic arms to heavy machinery to medical equipment, so it can be used on any kind of application. It's optimized in size and runtime, so the library is. Well, just to give you a number, for the F0 library, is about 10 kilobytes of binary code, so it's quite small. As I said, it's verified by fault injection, so there is a quantitative evidence of the coverage provided by this library. And, of course, the design is modular, so if you want, you can run this library all at once and test everything in one go. But maybe you don't want to do that. Maybe you want to. You need to interrupt, so you need. You want to split the test in small chunks. This is possible. So it's especially for the RAM test, which is the one that needs the interrupt to be disabled. So the test is organized into slices. So you can run all these slices, or you can test all the RAM all at once, or you can divide it into slices. So it's up to you how much of the RAM you want to test in one go. So this is to allow flexibility to the library. And then, of course, this library has been designed according to the IEC 61508, but is compatible also with other standards. So if you go through the documentation, you will see how to map this library also in other standards. What is this library actually? So we deliver the source code, which is C and assembly, and we deliver the compiled scripts. So far we support Kyle and Yar, which are the most common used. And then there is the documentation of the library, so there is the user guide, and there is the safety manual of the library. So basically, you have two safety manuals, one of the microcontroller, which is owned by ST, and then there is a safety manual of our library, and that we usually, for evaluation, we send to interested customers. So this is what we support right now. So we support we have libraries for the F0, F1, F2, F3, F4, and L1. I have to mention that we support all part numbers. So as you know, the STM32 has a lot of part numbers, but we support all of them. And by the way, we have a corner here inside the ST booth. We have two demos, one running on the F0, the other one on the F3. So if some of you is interested, please go and talk to my colleague. He will show you the demo, and also we can have a look. You can have a look at the code to understand how it works. And that's it. So basically, thanks to this software library, you can use STM32 also for safety projects.